I can just pull him in. Pull him as needed. No, it's the comedy and despair masks. Look on those stone statues. There's an achievement to get up this without getting hit.
So, even from the shackles of death, my old enemy pursues me. You're too late, Fortescue. Already my army has risen from the grave. You will never leave this necropolis.
What I find kind of interesting is there's a voice line that was cut from this version of the game to deal with the gargoyles that existed in the original, and I don't know why it was cut or never actually brought in. Or at least
some
if I remember
obstructions
right, it was
can
cut.
Be smashed down with clubs and certain other weapons. Try experimenting.
I wonder if I open my blinds.
These boulders are going to crush your bones if you aren't careful. I hope you have a good shield equipped. Remember that each hit on your shield will chip away at its durability. Better it than you, though.
I don't think the normal boulders can go down those slopes. I think it's only the vaulted ones that can. I'm just going to inspect it just to double check. Because if it is, I know how I can get through this. Because I just gotta go into those pockets when there's normal boulders coming, but avoid them when there's molten coming. Yeah, it does seem molten ones are the only ones going through that. Okay. Also, I've never figured out what the purpose of these fake chests are. They're like fake chests. So possible. Dude, I didn't notice you were
there
before.
Of great archaeological interest. Destroy the boulder and plunder the valuable treasures within.
I'd absolutely love to do that. I would. It'd be great if I could. But I need the club first. Yeah, because even if I try to. Okay, this is gonna be interesting, so I gotta wait for the right moment to go. Right now. Nope, not getting an achievement now. Okay, Ow. Why am I not able to get into this hole?
We have failed the master. We give our lives.
The adventurer would be wise to be thorough in the exploration.
Because I think you're able to get the achievement as long as you don't take damage, but I'm also not 100% sure. I have no spare shields, which is depressing. Luckily for me, I can get me a spare shield. I think there's a shield on this hill, if I remember. I can find it. I can get the club too, if I drop down that little gap right there, I believe. There's my shield. I'm just gonna collect the other goodies that are along the hill.
Club is a crude but effective weapon. Bash with it, burn with it, but beware, one bash too many, and it will break.
Clubs are good for getting stuff that you need to burn. There's not a whole lot you really need to do with the club early game. Especially because you get a hammer pretty early on, all things considered. As long as you're effective. Your movements and such.
Ah, fresh air. We hate these dark old caves and their filthy stench of old witches. A coven of the warty old hags lived here once. Unholy fires burning all night while they brewed up unspeakable muck in their cauldrons. They moved on years back, but the smell still makes our eyes sting.
Ooh, I might be able to transfer these files to my SD card, which will free up. Ugh. That sucked. Free up a lot of space. Let's put them in the movies folder. Just because it'll be easy to find. I don't have any.
A guide to covens for witches and witchcraft enthusiasts. A witch's coven would reach the height of its power only when all of their sacred flames were alight. Witches have been known to offer help to the questing adventurer, yet they are a reclusive people and have to be summoned by the aid of mystic charms or talismans. Let it be known that help from a witch is rarely given freely, and the witch will more often than not make a request of the adventurer before any such help is given. If seeking to summon a witch, remember that they are quite territorial. Any signs of previous witch activity in an area is a good indication that a witch can be called upon.
Nice. I didn't mean to run through it. Talisman. Getting the platinum trophy on this is not going to be easy, I can already tell. Now hopefully once I transfer these three files, which are like a gig and a half large, I can use space.
Back from the battle so soon? It must think it is a hero by now. But only a true hero is worthy of a place in the Hall of Heroes. See the ghostly statue of your fraudster self? When it has turned solid, a true hero you will be.
I'll show you. I'm a hero.
Hurrah! I knew it would take more than the army of the evil dead to throw your strides up. I've something that may help you on your quest, Captain. I give it to you freely, though I have no idea what it is.
Okay, and I'm gonna do one thing just because it's gonna be beneficial for the long run. Okay.
You are entering a house of pain. Rumors abound of evil doings in the secret catacombs below this very hall. Watch out for sticky-fingered imps. These thieves will strip you down to your armored undies. Rumor has it they fence their stolen wares with the merchant gargoyles.
Last time I did this, I beat it in like 8 hours, I think. Let's see if I can actually beat it less than that. Mainly because I know what I'm doing this time around. Okay. Now, give me back my sword. I've also never lost my sword or any weapons.
The stained glass demon is the master of the mausoleum. His wretched soul lies preserved inside a frozen glass heart. Shrouded in a veil of darkness beneath the mausoleum, you will find this pre-frozen menace.
Right.
Thank you.
I love the stadium floor, how it looks like Medusa.
The would-be Phantom longs to play a new tune, but he seems doomed to repeat the same cause of despair over and over.
You know, he unlocks the chalice if you get him a thingy. You get a shortcut here. Let's do this. Stained, stained glass beam. Fight will I.
Thank you.
might want to ever block and kind of hide your path from which harm away. Of heroes. Okay, so now it's saying that they're in the SD card. Which is good, because that means I should, technically speaking, have more space now? Technically? I don't know how that video is going to turn out.
It's the Hall of Heroes shopping mall. Bargain hunters should check out the ground floor. Well-to-do shoppers should check out the upper floor. That's where it's at.
As the game progresses, you get more and more stuff. unfortunately, you're kind of forced to do certain things.
Fortescue! Like, what's this I hear about that Archcad Zarok still being alive? Thought you killed the fella. Never mind, you old warhorse. Better show him what's what, eh? I expect Johnny's zombie's a bit more of a handful than you remember. How are you doing for weapons? Here, take my warhammer. It'll smash anything and it won't fall apart like a club. I only ever get to use it cracking walnuts around this place. Nonsense, Fortescue. I won't take no for an answer. Knock a few heads for old Stanyar Ironhewer, eh? There is one area I'm going to be having to do because you can't fight anything that's actually in that area. So it's like, if you see a human, you can't attack them, which makes it a little bit of a pain. If I can remember how to actually get over to that. Mm-hmm.
pop off my healing salves. Because I know that one jump is gonna fail quite a few times. It instantly kills the player if you fall in the water, so. Might as well just go become prepared for failure. Because if you're prepared for failure, it's only success. Hello, zombie is suddenly here, even though I remember killing him. And I missed, even though I somehow connected. They're somehow invisible? Because you can jump on those, because there's supposed to be a secret you need to access. There you go. Golly jeez. Lost two lives for this.
Who's a clever skeleton then? Remember that there are many more secret areas like this throughout the land of Galamir, some offering more than just treasure.
Interesting. I'm not actually doing it. There we go. I'm not gonna worry about that one enemy who's just sitting over there. I just wanna kill that one dude because he's like right there. Just in case, if push comes to sub, I can run back and kill that one dude if I need to. I don't think I will though, because they usually give you enough. Because this is the era where it was like meant for little kids to play. To where it's still meant to be challenging for them. But easy enough. So where there's challenges meant for adults, and then there's challenges meant for kids. That the chalices weren't too difficult, except for this one level where you can't kill the freaking humans.
Want to be faster on your feet? Want to be able to bash down walls by charging into them? All you have to do is defeat the evil guardians of the graveyard and gain this new ability. You will never know why you left the grave without it.
Dope. I got stuck on this boss for a depressingly long time. My first playthrough. I honestly don't know why. Well, I mean, I know why, because when you go down here, it's like, oh, it's just a single room. No, it's not. There's freaking passageways over here because it doesn't let you rotate the camera. This way again. Which can become very disorienting, like that. Oh, no. chalice. Good. That was odd. I was stuck inside of a wall. Anyway, I wasn't permanently stuck. That was sus. I could do a shortcut, which just revolves around from the one I pushed down first, and then just jumping down onto it, because you can literally just skip doing these other two stones, which is good for speedrunning, I guess. Actually, I don't even think you have to push down any of the stones, come think about it. I think you probably just jump from the ledge and jump around, but I'm doing the 100% completion playthrough, because that's what I did last time, and I did it again. This was a nice game. I love this game. In the original game, it's also a lot weirder. A lot harder because it's more clunky. So they definitely refined it in this version.
Has changed outside the necropolis. Pearls go this way, pearls go that way. Nasty, painful death waits round every turn and over every hill. Bon voyage.
Some of the other chaps wagered Zarok would be using your ribcage as a toast rack by now. But I knew you'd pull through. Here, I have a little extra something here I can give you. Could help the old quest. You want it?
Not as helpful as, like, a weapon or armor. can't wait to get the super sword as well as the golden shield. The golden shield's the best. It still breaks, but it's like takes a long time for it to break. I know the Enchanted Earth's a pain in the ass to do. I might end this stream here though, simply because I am getting actually extremely tired. I've been up since 9 p.m. I fell asleep and woke up at 9 p.m. Sucks. So I've technically been up for like 9 stream more. I still got a whole bunch of editing to do on for my Doom Eternal, and then I still gotta get the first half. I actually have the second half downloaded first, which I probably shouldn't have done. That was a mistake. Getting the second half of it downloaded, which is like an 8-hour stream compared to like I think it was a 3-hour stream was the previous one. But I will try and stream as much as I can. I will try and also potentially get everything up on my YouTube. I'll try and get some neat little clips for TikTok, and try to make some YouTube shorts out of it as well. But if you guys like this video, wanna go check out some other content, I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.